In this lecture, I will introduce the bada development environment. First, I will explain about the SDK and IDE that are used to develop an application and then execute a sample application. Then, I will explain what a simulator is and show you how to create a simple application. To develop a bada application, you have to download the SDK first. You can download the SDK from developer.bada.com. If you click on the Development Tools tab, you can download the SDK. To use the SDK, you need a computer with Microsoft Windows, at least 1.4 gigabytes of memory, at least 1.8 gigabytes of free disk space, and the administrator privilege. In addition, since the simulator requires a 480 by 800 resolution, you need a screen that supports this resolution or higher. Unfortunately, the Mac and Linux operating systems are not supported. I will briefly explain how to install the SDK. Download the SDK setup file, double-click on the setup file to start the installation, and select the required language pack. The installer automatically downloads and installs the language pack. In general, for the other steps, just click the Next button to proceed. After the installation, when you launch the bada IDE for the first time, a window with 5 buttons appears as shown in this slide. The Overview, API Reference, Developer Guide, Application UI Guide buttons are to view bada development documents, and the last button, Workbench, is the button to enter the IDE. If you click on the Workbench button, the following screen will appear. By default, Project Explorer is displayed on the left. The Resource Explorer is at the bottom, and the largest area in the center is the editing area. Sample applications are listed on the right. At the bottom, there is a window where you can view the compilation results, console, runtime output, and properties. Now I will build and run a sample application. As I mentioned earlier, we can select an application from the sample application list on the right. We'll select the basic app application. If you right-click on an application, the Copy into My Workspace menu option will appear. Click this menu option. After a moment, the copied project appears in the Project Explorer. To run this project, click the Build button in the toolbar. When the build is complete, click the Execute button in the toolbar. Then you will be asked to select an execution environment. We'll select Simulator Application. Then the simulator is launched and initialized. If you are running the simulator for the first time, you have to set the current locale and the time zone. When the initialization is complete, the application will run automatically. Now let's have a look at the simulator functions in detail. The appearance of the simulator interface is the same as the WavePhone. The buttons are also the same as those of the WavePhone. There are volume buttons on the left, and there are also call, end, home, and camera buttons. The simulator provides functions to rotate the simulator, to look up errors, to manage the database on the phone, to set the simulator to always on top, and to resize the simulator screen. In addition, the simulator has an event injector. Basically, the bada platform runs as an event-driven type. Therefore, the simulator can generate events to simulate network or telephony functions. For example, the simulator can generate events that occur when a call arrives, an SMS arrives, the phone orientation changes, or any other sensor states change. Now, let's take a look at the Project Explorer in detail. The Project Explorer lists project components. From the top, the binary is the executable file for the phone or simulator. Next, we have the include path, and then the source files that we will use. Then the header files are listed and the application icons are also listed. There is also the group res. This group is a set of resources necessary for the application. The contents of this group will be copied to the phone when the application is installed on the phone. Finally, you will find the application.xml and the manifest.xml files. These files are the application setting files. Let's have a look at the application settings in more detail. The application settings file contains the application name, icon, vendor, description, application version, hardware setting, and privilege setting information. These files are automatically created when the application is created and cannot be changed in the IDE. Now let's have a look at the source files in more detail. First, we have the basic app.cpp file. This file controls the application lifecycle. User interactions and the user interface are implemented in the form 1, 2, or 3.cpp files. These files implement the functions to receive user inputs, generate corresponding outputs, display the outputs on the screen, and manipulate the UI. Then there is the form mgr.cpp, the form manager file. This Form Manager file contains the code to manage Form 1, 2, and 3, and to perform transitions between them. Finally, we have the basic app entry.cpp file. This file is the actual main entry point. This file should not be modified, as editing the content may cause problems, so it is recommended to leave it as it is. In general, the application name entry.cpp file performs the role of the main .cpp file in a C program. This file consists of functions to run the actual application class and to return the error code from the application. Again, let me remind you, it is not recommended to edit this file. Now, let's see how we can create a bada project using this bada IDE. First, to create a bada project, launch the IDE. Then click on File, New, and then the bada application project from the menu bar. The application template appears. This application template performs the same role as the Visual Studio Wizard. First, you have to enter the project name. I type test as the project name. Then select the project type. You can select one of five types: a bada frame-based application, a bada form-based application, a bada empty project, a bada dynamic library, and a bada static library. The bada frame-based application has been developed for applications that use the full screen. Therefore, we would select the frame-based application when developing an application using OpenGL ES. However, the bada form-based application can perform almost the same functionality, and we've selected form-based application. Then, we have to define the manifest. As mentioned earlier, the manifest stores the application settings. For example, the manifest stores the hardware information necessary for the application and the application settings. Since this is a simple example, I've selected the default manifest file. Since an application developed using the default manifest cannot be sold on Samsung apps, you should use a custom manifest for commercial applications. We'll cover this process later. Next, you have to define the form name. Here, I've specified the form name as test form. When the project is created, the Project Explorer will show this result. As you have seen in the previous example, the CPP files are created in the source folder, and the header files are created in the INC folder, and the resources are automatically prepared. Let's look at each of them in more detail. The components that appear here are essential to create an application. For example, the include group has the path of the system header files necessary for the application, and INC and SRC contain the most important source code in the project. The home group is where the application data is stored. Basically, the files saved in the home group are copied to the phone or simulator when the application is installed. As I mentioned previously, although the res group performs a similar role, the home group can be used in more widely. As I mentioned previously, the res group performs a similar role. The home group can be used more widely because the application can read from and write to the data in the home group. The project name.png and splash.png files are in the icons group. The project name.png is the project icon, and the splash.png is the image that appears for a short time when the application is launched. To sell the application on Samsung apps, you cannot use the default splash.png as it is. You will need to replace the file with an appropriate image for your application. As I mentioned earlier, the res group includes the UI design and various resource files necessary for the application, such as the image, the localized string, and so on. Now, let's build and run this project. You can build and run it in the same way as the sample application. When the application is launched, you will see that the splash screen appears on the screen for a short time, and then the form appears on the black background. At the top of the form, there is a title bar with the Hello Bada title. In the center of the screen is an OK button. If you press the OK button, you will see the OK button is clicked message appearing in the log. This indicates that the application is working normally. In summary, this lecture covered how to install the SDK, how to use the IDE, and how to create and set up a project.